become cynical, to be critical, to have nothing positive to say. But I think these young people here feel that the system can be changed, that they can make a difference in their lives to make this a still better America.
Saying they're a small but dedicated group, members of the Augustana Young Democrats chose the Sunday night meeting as a way of reaching fellow students and perhaps doing a little recruiting at the same time. From the Augie Commons, Ron Simon, Sioux First News.
A union organizer in Sioux Falls says workers should support a bill in Congress that would raise the federal minimum wage. Bob Kingsley says he's collected some 1,500 signatures from people in our state who favor raising the wage. It's $3.35 an hour right now, and the plan calls for an increase of $1.30 an hour, which would put minimum wage at $4.65 an hour. Kingsley says South Dakota could benefit greatly from a higher minimum wage because it ranks low in wages among states. In Minnehaha County, someone is arrested for DWI nearly every day of the week. Those drivers are risking their own lives as well as others when they get behind the wheel of their car. Pennington County is looking at a new way to deal with those problems. Ron Brown has details.
This accident in Rapid City 2 weeks ago claimed the lives of four people, including a three-month-old boy. Police say it was alcohol-related. The number of alcohol-related deaths like this one on our highways are increasing. Through September 30th, 46 people have died in alcohol-related accidents in South Dakota. The Pennington County Mad Chapter wants to get tougher on DWIs. They think a task force to get the community involved will help. Harry Kohler told the Pennington County Law Committee today how the task force works in North Dakota.
The task forces serve to localize the traffic safety issue. It brings it home to where it belongs in terms of injuries and deaths and so forth. And only a local community can respond appropriately to the issue of DUI and traffic safety.
Now, the state has the highway safety program, and we have people that work under state government that are already dealing with this program. But we deal with that in Rapid City also. We deal with it in Sioux Falls and in Aberdeen and here in Brookings. But none of us ever get together to address these problems and see what is identical and how we should best handle them. So a task force as they proposed or modified might be very good for us.
So far, no DWI task force exists in South Dakota. If approved, the task force would be an independent body. Who will pay for it still has to be worked out.
That was Ron Brown reporting from our sister station in Rapid City. Well, as you may know, some state lawmakers are working on a new mandatory seatbelt law. Supporters of the idea often use a lot of statistics to get their point across. But will those statistics help collect enough support to pass a new law next year? Doug Aronson tonight examines that question in the final part of his series.
The numbers are alarming. There is an 86% chance that you'll be involved in a motor vehicle accident. 91% of the people killed in car accidents were not wearing seatbelts. And they go on. 3 out of every 4 traffic accidents happen within 25 miles of the home. 58% of all fatalities occur in rural areas like those in South Dakota. But 21 states, including South Dakota, still do not have a mandatory seatbelt law.
Statistics are relevant only to the person who's putting them out. I have statistics that would indicate in states where there are mandatory seatbelt laws that, in fact, the death toll has gone up.
That might be one reason why this bill has failed before in the legislature. But supporters are feeling more confident that when this issue comes up again in January, that it will pass. And here is part of their reasons. Economically.
People that are spending time in hospitals, running up huge medical bills. And
statistically,
your chances of having of escaping serious injury or death are cut by better than 50% if you're wearing a safety belt.
And graphically,
this is what can happen to an unprotected occupant in a car crash.
My aunt and uncle just rolled their car two weeks ago now, and they had their seatbelt on and minor injuries.
Stories like these aren't exactly new to lawmakers, but they have proven effective.
For example, there is a law that says all children under the ages of 5 years old must be strapped into one of these child safety seats, but the penalty doesn't go into effect until January 1st.
Definitely it's a step in the right direction, and hopefully it'll show people that the seatbelt laws do work. They do motivate people to buckle up.
The new bill also has a provision that says you could not be fined unless you were pulled over for another violation. However, even coupled with the endorsements from law enforcement agencies, it remains to be seen if the legislature wants to buckle down on buckling up. Doug Aronson, Sioux First News.
One of the new laws passed during this past year's legislative session is the lottery bill, and tickets for the state's second lottery game go on sale at midnight tonight. The new game is called Gold Rush. It has the same format as the first game. You win by scratching and matching, but instead of matching numbers, you'll be matching symbols. And there's also an additional $10 prize category this time. Well, still to come tonight on Sioux First News, a man goes berserk during a morning church service in Texas. And the FBI has been called in to help settle a hostage situation in Louisiana.
Avoid the noid with the Domino's Pizza Guarantee. We guarantee your pizza will be delivered within 30 minutes or you get $3 off your order. Guaranteed. And we guarantee your pizza will taste great. If you're not satisfied with your pizza, we'll replace it or refund your money. Only our pizza is guaranteed to avoid the noid. Domino's Pizza delivers. Call now.
So things are going well at work.
Yeah, we're considering expansion, but we don't know where to go.
Look! What's going on?
Office furniture on the interstate.
And office products, too? I know. That's Interstate Office Products.
We're Interstate Office Products. But don't look for us on the interstate. We're at 220 and 228 South Main in downtown Sioux Falls.
We cover it all at the floor-to-ceiling store. Yes, we cover everything for your entire home, all under one roof, featuring the most elegant products for remodeling your new bathroom, or choose from over 40 styles of beautifully designed kitchen cabinets. Let our experienced decorators help you coordinate wall coverings, paint blends, or window treatments. With the largest selection of beautifully displayed floor coverings, we can add the finishing touches to make your house a home. The floor-to-ceiling store, Mitchell and Sioux Falls.
KDLT invites you to discover the Sioux Empire. This week we travel to Centerville. Tree-lined and picturesque, Centerville is situated on the banks of the Vermilion River. Centerville is full of exciting school-related activities, home to the Centerville Tornadoes, and host to the annual Toilet Bowl Races. Townspeople gather at Petter Larson Park, built with donations of time and money by local people. Make sure you visit the friendly town of Centerville, and while you're there, stop by Calico Cat. Thousands of various country craft items in a general store atmosphere.
People attending a church service in Fort Worth, Texas today had a hard time believing what they saw. A man in the church suddenly pulled out a knife and began stabbing worshipers. Police say the man attacked at least 11 people before he could be stopped. That attack happened at St. Patrick's Cathedral in downtown Fort Worth. No one was killed, but the attacker sent at least 6 people to the hospital. Police say there's no explanation for the man's behavior. Meantime, a tense standoff continues tonight at a federal detention center in Louisiana. The FBI has now been called in to help. Cuban aliens are holding more than 20 people hostage. The Cubans are upset about a decision to send them back to Cuba. The trouble began last night when the refugees took over the facility, setting fire to several buildings. Hundreds of police and National Guardsmen are surrounding the center at this hour, but so far no deal has been struck. Well, as Thanksgiving approaches, many of us take the time to notice things we should be thankful for. Take medical achievements, for example. Tonight, Dr. Red Duke tells us about one field of medicine many people take for granted.
You know, this is the time of year that we take time to ponder those things for which we have to be thankful. Oh, Dan. There's a bunch of things in medicine about which to be thankful if you stop and think about it. You know, the field of anesthesiology has not been as sophisticated as it is today. In fact, it used to be downright barbaric in some cases.
Well, in the ancient days, Egyptians were known to knock the patients out either by getting them drunk or hitting them overhead even to operate on them.
But fortunately, things changed. And one of the great advances in the history of medicine was the invention or discovery of ether.
In the early days, anesthesia was given used by whoever walked down the hall, orderly or a janitor, just to pour open drop ether.
And with ether, there was always the underlying fear of an explosion. However, today, anesthesiology has advanced to an incredibly sophisticated science.
we're just beginning to hit all the improvements, and it seems like every year something new comes out and makes it more safer.
I think we owe a real debt of thanks to pioneers like Dr. Slatifer for helping medicine become what it is today for us. From the University of Texas Health Science Center at Houston, I'm Dr. Red Dew.
And if you're like most Americans, you'll probably be heading to grandmother's house for Thanksgiving dinner. The American Automobile Association says almost 29 million people will take trips of more than 100 miles this coming holiday weekend. That's up about 8% from last year. And the best news of all is gas prices in our area will be a couple of cents a gallon lower than they were over Labor Day weekend. So how about you, Carl? Are you heading over to grandmother's house?
Yeah, I am going to grandmother's, but I'm not going to take my horse like Dr. Red do. I'm going to take my truck. So
how's the weather?
The weather is not looking too bad if you're a snow lover. We